So, guess what happened? This happened! Yay! We almost died. We almost died. Look at this. Hello, it's a nice day outside at the moment. I think it's gonna get hotter during the day. But I'm about to go to the sewer thing that's right down the street and I'm gonna film a dance video because I'm bored. See my board? Look, that's me. Bad news, the camera died right when I was recording. Sometimes I forget to charge the batteries, but anyway, Edwin's gonna pick me up and we're gonna go do some more training today, I think, or just chill. Whatever we do, I'll be recording it. I'm definitely going to be doing that sewer thing again another day, though.
Please.
We're gonna go to the wetlands and my glasses are broken. The problem with going out and training and bringing a camera is that I have no one to really film me, and I don't like asking people to film me, and I usually get lazy when I'm out training because I just want to focus on my training, and then I end up never really recording anything. So I'm going to try to get some nice footage today. I'm waiting for it to fall. We're here because we're going to get a speaker to train music.
JBL speakers.
Yeah, I know. I want the charge.
Soundly color boots and RGB.
Yeah. No speaker because Edwin's too picky.
I'm sorry, man. If I don't love it in the store, I don't buy it.
You're beautiful. It's true.
So we just got in a really bad car crash. We were going, the light was green. That lady right there, that's parked right there. She was red. And she made a left turn. She wasn't supposed to go. And we were going and we ended up hitting her. And we span and we ended up hitting the light pole. What happened was we were going this way and this person had to yield right of way to that thing. And then they didn't and they turned and then we ended up and then boom, we went straight into this pole. Okay, are you okay? Are you okay?
Are you guys okay? We should ask that first. Yeah.
So that's your mom. She wasn't.
She was in the car ahead of me.
Was it because you were trying to follow her and you didn't want to lose her? You don't want to lose track of her?
Well, I knew where she was going, but I thought you guys were far away enough.
Oh no. This is where we got hit.
It's good footage though.
I'm shaking a little bit. But I'm like...
this arm is heavier. It feels heavier.
Truck and the ambulance left. Things are sort of dying down. I'm starting to stop shaking.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, good thing we're okay. It was just sucks because we just saw it coming.
While you were filming.
I wish I was filming. That would have been so crazy. That would have been awesome footage.
Dope footage.
That would have been awesome vlog footage. But we're definitely going to look back at this.
Worst/best day ever.
Yeah, at least we're still alive.
Yeah.
We didn't get to train today, but at least... we got some kind of adrenaline.
Let me throw a back talk right now.
Yeah, let's go. Positives. Wait, let's go. Let's both do it. Let's both do it.
Two.
We're okay. Fuck.
Airbag
this is
deployed.
The first time I've seen airbags.
Same.
But I don't think they did anything for us.
I don't know what this is. I don't know what this is.
Oh, I think
two. There's two.
It's part of this. Yeah. Wait, is that?
No, it's not.
Or is it just? Yeah, I think it's just part of the car. cool. Now we can learn about cars and what's inside the cars. Yeah.
Oh my god!
I just want to help you guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome. No problem. I just see you there. My kids are like, Mom, help them. I was like, yeah, no problem. I don't know what it is with this corner, but I don't know if it's a blind spot, but this is the worst freaking corner.
The interior all fell off. Airbag. I'm gonna take pictures of their car, see what the damage is. I'm not sure if they can drive their car. Go! Touch it! Ooh! Thank you.
Bye.
All right, so we're back at Edwin's. We're safe, and he's getting a rental car tomorrow morning.
Yes, tomorrow. And I'm driving to the car tomorrow.
Thankfully, we're all okay. Alan joined us. Thank you for
assisting in whatever way you did.
Yeah, for supporting.
Yeah. Moral fiber.
My mom.
Shower. I feel like the accident made me stink.
So much for training, but at least we got to flip around the car.
I didn't even know the airbag deployed.
Me neither.
Airbag. That sucks.
I thought an airbag would be bigger. But like, we hit the pole, so I thought my airbags would have gone off too. Wear a seatbelt. Mom just got here.
Hi. This is Ace.
You okay?
Yeah.
What happened?
That's where we were at. My mom's picking me up. Right there. So he went whoosh, 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 whoosh.
Go! Go!
So I made it back home. Something's really wrong with my back. Like, I didn't feel anything at first, but I'm starting to feel the aftershock of the car crash. This was the worst car crash I've ever been in. I'm just glad that we're all okay. Hey guys, so now I'm in my room. I'm in a different state of mind at the moment. About to go to sleep, and I was just thinking about what happened today and the experience of getting into a pretty bad car crash. And I just want to capture my thoughts right now as I'm thinking them, so that I can look back on them and just to share it with you guys. Once I got home from Edwin's house, I wanted to dance for some reason. I wanted to dance, one, because I wanted to see what my body could do. I started feeling a little bit weird in my body. Probably the adrenaline, once the crash happened, I didn't feel it. But yeah, now I'm starting to feel some soreness in my body, in my neck, in my upper back, and just all over my body. I'm starting to feel really sore. But I just wanted to test what my body was capable of. So once I got home, I turned on the camera and just started dancing. And honestly, I'm not really one to really share how I truly dance with other people, especially in person. I don't feel the need to really share who I am as a dancer. My dance has always been very spiritual and very precious and special to me. And I enjoy dancing for myself. And if people see it, people see it. But when people try to force me to be myself to them, then I just don't enjoy that. And it's rare for me to actually capture the essence of how I really dance on camera too, because when there's a camera in front of me, it's just different than when you're just dancing alone. But this time was different. After experiencing the car crash and looking back over the freestyles that I did, I started realizing that this is me living through my dance.
Midnight, and
come and pick you up. No headlights, no headlights. Long drive, let him burn in flames of paradise. Paradise, fade into view. It's been a while since I have heard from you. Watch go round and round each time.
I got that changing daydream. Look in my eye, you got that breathing classic thing that I like.
And you find, not more that I've been out and about with some other girls.
No father figure in the house, and I'm wondering how I'm gonna work it out. Oh, my friends keep on telling me how I don't need that man, but they don't really understand.
I think it was because of the car crash. Really quick, let me move on. After the dancing, I went up to my room and I'm FaceTiming my girlfriend Madeline right now. And I was talking to her and she was very worried. I Snapchatted it at the beginning of this vlog, you probably saw it. But I Snapchatted the experience, and then when she saw it on Snapchat, she texted me asking me if I was okay. And she was really worried. She said her heart dropped when she saw the Snapchat. Once I saw her, I was just smiling. I couldn't stop smiling. I couldn't stop laughing because I was just so happy to see her and to see her face and to be home and to be alive. And when I couldn't stop smiling, she would just kind of get like a little irritated. She called me terrible because I was just smiling. I was telling her that it's okay, I'm here, and I'm here to make you feel better. And she was like, she didn't want me to see her cry. And I was like, no, I want to see you cry. And she just didn't understand why I just kept smiling. And then I proceeded to tell her why I was smiling without kind of thinking about it. Having an experience like that, where it could have been so much worse, it makes you more grateful for the things that you have. And that's how I felt when I saw her. I was so happy to see her. I was so happy to see her face, and to whether she was crying, whether she was smiling or not, I was just happy to see her face. I was happy to see my mom when she picked me up. I was happy to see my family. And I was happy to see my messy room. And I was happy to be able to dance. And I was happy to look back at my dancing and to see what I was feeling from all of this. Like, without even realizing it, I didn't even know that it had such a big effect on me until I sat down in my bed and just started thinking. I was smiling and laughing because, yeah, things could have been way worse. And another thing that I realized when I was sitting here in my bed just reassessing the whole situation was that if something bad, really bad, were to happen, where I wasn't here anymore, I realized that I wouldn't have any regrets. And I think that's pretty cool to say for myself, that I have no regrets if something were to happen to me and I were to leave this place today or tomorrow or any time, I would have no regrets. Because I've come to a point in my life where I'm starting to actively follow my heart and follow the things that I believe in and pursue the things that I want to pursue, regardless of what people say to me, even though it's difficult, it's challenging, because I'm sticking with what makes me feel like I'm getting the most out of my life and helping other people. Because I'm doing that, I have no regrets. And I think that's so powerful for me, that I could leave today and be completely okay, feel completely content with the way things are in my life. The me that I would leave behind, I would be completely okay with, because I stayed true to who I am. And I came to a point where I allowed myself to learn more about myself and to explore my own mind and my own passions, and I'm thankful and grateful that I'm like this. And I'm thankful and grateful for all the people I've met and all the people who have been around, my family and my friends, and the people who say that I inspire them. And since I'm still here, which is a good thing, I still have a lot of time to continue being myself. When I said that to Madeline, she said, please do that. Please keep being you. I answered back, it's difficult. It's challenging, but I think I'm getting the hang of it. One of the big reasons why I want to capture my thoughts right now in this moment, exactly how they are being felt, the frequency that I'm having them in right now, is to show also how any bad situation can be turned into something else, a change in perspective. I see this bad car accident on my end, on the way it's relevant to me, not my friend who was also with me when this happened. The experience for me, being so close to that end, I've just come to see it as a blessing in disguise. It turned a pretty scary situation into something that I've learned so much from. In a single instant, within the few seconds that that happened, I felt alive. I felt exhilarated. I'm feeling pain. My body hurts. My body is sore. But I'm feeling it. I have the ability to feel things, to feel love, and to feel happy, and to feel sad, and to feel stressed. It just made me so grateful. And that I now have the ability to express the things that I want to express and be myself and show the world. There's a reason that my end wasn't there. And there's a reason that this happened. I choose to see it that way. If it gets me through the end of the day, then why not? You know? But I just want to share that with you guys. I hope you liked this video. If you enjoyed it, and because I'm still alive, please hit that like button and subscribe for more if you want to see more of my crazy, adventurous, and spontaneous life. I never know what's gonna happen to me next, but it's fun. Thank you all so much for watching, and until the next one, later.